audience to kindly switch your mobile phones to silent mode.
I declare the 10th convocation of Exam University open.
We shall have the prayer song now. Please remain standing. Thank you.
प्यारे प्रभु दिल में आ शांति दे हे तुझे समर्पण ये मेरा जीवन हे तुझे समर्पण ये मेरा जीवन प्यारे प्रभु दिल में आ शांति दे तुझ पे तरस करता मन कामना तेरी हर पल प्यासी आंखें तुझ पे तरस कामना तेरी हर पल हर क्षण तुझी को अर्पण करूं समर्पण ये जीवन हर क्षण तुझी को अर्पण करूं समर्पण ये जीवन
Request all of you to please be seated. Thank you, choir, for the beautiful moment of gratitude and appreciation. Your life is your story, and the adventure ahead of you is the journey to fulfill your potential and purpose. Namaskar and a very good morning, ladies and gentlemen, esteemed dignitaries, faculty and staff member, honored guests, members from the press and media, and the most importantly, the graduating class of 22-24 with their proud parents. I am Jigisha Das, and it is my distinct privilege to welcome you all to XIM University's convocation ceremony. We will have now Ms. Mavia Luke to welcome our chief guest and convocation speaker, Shri R. Mukundan, Managing Director and CEO, Tata Chemicals Limited. We will request Ms. Aishwarya Paharaj to welcome Father Jairam Kutina SJ, Chairman of the Board of Governors. We will request Ms. Preeti Sharma to welcome Shri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus of the Board of Governors. We will now request Ms. Caroline DeCosta to present a welcome bouquet to Father Anthony R. Overy, SJ, Vice Chancellor, XIM University. And now, we request Ms. Rosa Mascaria to present a welcome bouquet to Father S. Anthony Raj, SJ, Registrar, XIM University. Thank you. I now request Professor Vishwaswarup Mishra, Dean, Xavier Institute of Management, to deliver the welcome address.
Good morning to all. Esteemed dignitaries on the dais, respected members of the Board of Governors, deans, faculty members, staff, students, parents, invited guests, and members of the media present in this auditorium. It is my privilege and pleasure to extend a very warm welcome to each one of you to XIM University for the postgraduate convocation ceremony for the year 2024. My dear graduating students, this day marks the culmination of your hard work and perseverance. This is an auspicious occasion and a day of celebration. We have an illustrious audience, including your parents, to celebrate your success. A very hearty and warm welcome to each one of you parents. Dear parents, you had entrusted your faith in us, and we are delighted to have the privilege of your trust. We sincerely welcome Sri Mukundan, who has kindly agreed to be the convocation speaker to make this celebration memorable for all of us. Sri Mukundan is widely recognized as an able and stable leader in navigating organizations towards excellence in India's fast-changing business landscape. I extend a warm welcome to Sri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus, who has been a constant support for the entire XIM University fraternity for close to 3 decades. As a friend, philosopher, and guide, Sri Kaul has played a key role in the establishment and evolution of XIM University. I welcome the alumni, invited dignitaries who have spared their valuable time to enrich today's celebration. Universities are sacred institutions that are engaged in knowledge creation, dissemination, and application. The aim of education is knowledge, not of facts, but of values. You would have witnessed these words of William Inge being practiced day in and day out during your stay in XIM University. The 5 values of the XIM University: integrity, excellence, inclusiveness, compassion, and sustainability can be encapsulated in the 3 C's: character, commitment, and compassion. Graduating students, you would have experienced that XIM University fosters pursuit of knowledge coupled with the ever values in keeping with its motto, Semper Excelsius, meaning ever higher. This has been possible because of the visionary leadership of Father Anthony Uvari, our Vice Chancellor, with strategic input from the Board of Governors and unfettered commitment of all the stakeholders, especially the faculty members. Dear students, as you embark on a new journey, it is apt to recall the words of philosopher Ralph Emerson. To quote Emerson, "What lies behind us and what lies before us are small matters compared to what lies within us," unquote. Thus, always remember that what lies within you is not only the knowledge, but more importantly, the values of XIM University that you have imbibed during the last 2 years. These values will give you the strength to face challenges in both the personal and professional front. I wish you all the very best in your personal and professional endeavors. Have a great life ahead. With these words of gratitude and warmth, I welcome each one of you today to this auspicious and grand ceremony of the postgraduate convocation of 2024. Thank you. May God bless all.
Thank you, sir, for welcoming the gathering. I now respectfully invite our Vice Chancellor, Father Anthony R. Overy, S.J., to share the report on the university's progress and achievements. Father, please.
Sri R. Mukundan, Managing Director and CEO, Tata Chemicals Limited, the chief guest of the convocation today, esteemed members of the Governing Board of XIM University, deans and faculty members, staff members, graduating students, parents, dignitaries and invitees, members of the print and electronic media, ladies and gentlemen. I take this opportunity to warmly welcome you all to the 10th convocation of XIM University, Bhubaneswar. I thank the chairman for Jerome Kutina and the esteemed members of the Board of Governors, Board of Management, Academic Council, Finance Committee, and the Strategic Academic Advisory Board members for their constant guidance and support. My deepest thanks to the faculty, staff, students, SEC members, alumni, Jesuits, and all stakeholders for their kind support and encouragements at all times. My deep appreciation and thanks to the government of Odisha for their constant support and guidance. Our heartfelt gratitude to Sri R. Mukundan for gracing us with his presence today. There are a total of 643 students who are graduating this morning from the 22-24 batch. Among them are 6 doctoral students, 348 students from MBA in Business Management, 18 students from 1 year full-time MBA Executive Program 22-23 batch, 39 from the Executive PGDM VL Program 22-23 batch, 106 MBA HRM students, 51 students from MBA Rural Management, and 17 MBA Sustainability Management students. There are 9 students graduating from the MBA UMG, 5 students from MERP, 17 students from MMS BF, 12 students from MA in Mass Communications, 4 students from Master in Public Policy and Governance, and 5 students from MSc Economics, and 7 students from the Dual Masters MBA program in Sports Industry Management of Xavier M. Leon Business School. Many congratulations to each one of them as they step into a new world filled with possibilities and opportunities at this convocation. Exam university students have actively participated in various national, state, and university level competitions and won many prizes. My heartiest congratulations to each one of them. You would be happy to know that AMDISA has granted the SAQS accreditation for MBA BM, MBA HRM, MBA RM, Executive MBA BM, and PhD program as part of the Faculty of Management, Exam University, Bhubaneswar, for a period of 5 years from March 7th, 24 to March 7th, 2029. UGC has accorded Exam University under Section 12B of the UGC Act 1956. AICT extension of approval 2425 accorded for the MTech and BTech programs of the School of Computer Science and Engineering. Sri Navin Patnaik, Honorable Chief Minister of Odisha, laid the foundation stone for the new Loyola School, Gothpatna on February 26, 24. Father Jerome Kutina, Chairman, Board of Governors, and Sri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus, Board of Governors, Exam University, inaugurated the new UG Girls Hostel at the new campus on March 25, 2024. 798 students were admitted in the academic year 23-24 in the PhD and PG programs, while 636 students were admitted in 23-24 UG programs, totaling to 1,434 students who were admitted to various programs of the university. 558 students of the university secured final placements for the batch of 22-24, and 742 students secured summer internships successfully for the batch of 23-25. Inauguration of MBA BM, MBA HRM, MBA RM, MBA UMG, MBA SM, and MBA BF, MMS BF was held on June 27, 2023. Inauguration and orientation for all the first year UG programs and other PG programs was held on July 18th, 2023. The first year PhD program commenced on July 26th, 2023. This year, 116 UG students from first year, second year, and third year, and fourth year of undergraduate programs were awarded various scholarships by the university. The university spent around 1.3 crores for this noble cause. 20 doctoral students were provided stipends, one student was provided free ship. The 9th annual convocation of XIM University was held on April 21st, 2023. Sri Nadir Godrej, Chairman and Managing Director, Godrej Industries Limited, was the chief guest and convocation speaker. Sri Nadir Godrej was conferred with honorary doctoral degree in business management in the convocation 2023. The 7th UG convocation of XIM University was held on April 29th, 2023. We were privileged to have Professor Ghansi Lal, Honorable Governor of Odisha, as the chief guest and the convocation speaker. The Foundation Day celebration of Xavier Institute of Management, XIM University, was held on December 8th. Ms. Sunita Reddy, Managing Director, Apollo Enterprises Limited, delivered the Foundation Day lecture, and she was awarded the honorary doctoral degree in business management. XIM University participated in various rankings in 23-24, and we have been consistently ranked among the top business schools and universities in the country. 3 MBA BM students went to SGS Warsaw, Poland, and another MBA BM student went to University of Antwerp, Belgium, as part of the student exchange program in their 5th semester during September to December 2023. 4 UG students from the School of Commerce are participating in the student mobility program at Örebro University, Sweden, IQS Barcelona, and Universidad Loyola Andalusia, Cordoba campus in their 5th semester during January to June 2024. 4 UG students from various schools of the university participated in the MAGIS exchange program at Ateneo de Manila University, Philippines, Loyola University, New Orleans in the USA, Greektown University, USA, and Ateneo de Manila University, Philippines in their 5th semester during July to December 2023. 2 students from the School of Commerce are participating in the Student Mobility Erasmus program at FBB University of Antwerp from January to June 2024. Ronit Sahu, the Charmi Sudhya from the School of Commerce, participated in the iWeek on Sustainability 2024 at the Faculty of Business and Economics, University of Antwerp, from March 18 to 22, 2024. In the year 23-24, XIM University conducted 50 management development programs. There were 1,137 participants in total who were part of various training programs. My sincere appreciation to the faculty members, coordinators, who have coordinated and took sessions. Our faculty members published 7 books, 31 book chapters, 7 cases, 140 articles in international journals, and 14 articles in national journals this year. Apart from that, they presented 27 papers in international conferences and 16 papers in national conferences. 20 faculty members and 19 non-teaching staff joined the university during this academic year. We welcome them to the XIM family and look forward to their fruitful career ahead. 8 faculty members, Professor Gopal Krishnan Kauda, Professor Abdul Karim, Professor Manisha Chakrabarti, Professor Prince Bhatia, Professor Radha Govind Indwar, Professor Sanjay Bhattacharya, Professor Sipra Ram, and Professor Chetana Rath completed their PhD this year. Professor S. Pepin, Professor Manimai Ghosh, and Professor S. S. Singh retired from their services of XIM University in the year 2023. We thank them for their services to the university. We also had 4 non-teaching staff members, Ms. Sibani Roy, Mr. Susanda Mohanty, Mr. Manoranjan Samal, and Ms. Saliyamma Xavier, who retired from their services. We are very thankful to them for their devoted service to the university. The university has 6 centers of excellence, namely Center of Excellence in Fiscal Policy and Taxation, Center for Business and Society, Center for All Interacting Evolving System Science, Center for Corporate Governance, Center for Business Analytics and Digital Transformation, and Center for Humanities and Compassion Studies. The university has two journals, Vilakshan, XIMB Journal of Management, published biannually, and Journal of Case Research, online journal published biannually. XIMB University was privileged to connect with the alumni in conducting leadership talk, guest lectures, immersion courses, etc. We were privileged to host Mr. Ravi Kumar, Chief Executive Officer, Cognizant, to deliver a leadership talk to our students on February 11, 2024. Mr. Ravi Kumar is our alumni of the 94-96 batch, sharing on his rich industrial experience and insights into the leadership were extremely enriching and interesting. Our alumni's achievements gladdened our hearts as across India and globally, they scaled heights of success and made us all proud. We are proud of our alumni and wish them more success and wonderful lives ahead. We celebrate the long and dedicated service of faculty and staff who have served XIMB University for 15 years and more. Thank you. Your service to XIMB University is truly appreciated. Several workshops, seminars, symposiums, and conferences were organized by XIMB University in 23-24. I will not take your time by detailing various activities that were conducted at XIMB University over the past 1 year. They are provided in the convocation report, which is available on our website. I congratulate the graduating classes and wish them the best in life and hope and pray that may God watch over them as they progress in life and may their lives be filled with love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, and gentleness that would inspire many more to lead such lives. Thank you all, and may God bless you.
Thank you, Father, for presenting the accomplishments of the university. I extend a cordial invitation to the Chairman of the Board of Governors, Father Jerome Kutina SJ, to deliver the Chairman's address. Father, please.
The chief guests for the 10th convocation of XIMB University, Sri R. Mukundan, the members of the Board of Governors of XIMB University, Mr. Rajiv Kaul, Father Anthony Wori, Father S. Anthony Raj, the deans of the schools of XIMB University, the eminent guests, faculty, the staff, the graduating students with their proud parents and family members, and the alumni of XIMB. It is indeed my pleasure to extend a warm welcome to Sri R. Mukundan, who has graciously accepted our invitation to be the chief guest and deliver the convocation address. Thank you very much, sir. We look forward to listening to you. I would like to congratulate our students who are graduating today. Your accomplishments, the fruits of the toil, is the momentous achievement which would not have been possible without the support and encouragement of your parents, family, and friends. This day marks a significant milestone in your lives as you step out into the world armed with knowledge, skills and experiences gained during your time here. There is a story of a school teacher in a school who wrote a note on the report card which read like this. I quote, "Your son excels in initiative, group integration, responsiveness, and activity participation. Now, if he would only learn to read and write," unquote. Yes, I certainly can say that the report card of the university team has many A+ ratings for its teamwork and hard work. My sincere appreciation to the Vice Chancellor, the Registrar, the Deans of the schools, the faculty and the staff of Exam University for assisting the students on their developmental journey and for making Exam University a place of excellence and integrity. I place on record my sincere thanks and appreciation to the Chairman Emeritus, Mr. Rajiv Kaul, for all his contribution during his long association with XIMB. Seem to be 3 decades and really needs a round of applause. Thank for his leadership and valuable guidance to XIM. Dear graduating students, as we gather here to celebrate your achievements, I place before you the imagery of a tree growing in 2 directions, upward and downward. Imagine the tree whose branches reaching out to the sky, while its roots firmly delve deep into the earth. This imagery can symbolize the dual nature of human growth. The upward growth representing personal and professional development, your relentless pursuit of excellence, and the downward growth signifying the grounding in values and principles. Just like the branches of a tree stretch towards the sky, you too must strive to reach out to the new heights, to push the boundaries of knowledge, creativity, and thus make a meaningful contribution to society. However, while the upward growth is essential, it is equally important not to neglect the downward growth, the strengthening of your roots. The roots of a tree provide stability, nourishment, and resilience. Similarly, your grounding in values, ethics, integrity, and empathy forms the foundation of your character. It is what keeps you grounded amidst the storms of life, guides your decisions, and shapes your relationships. And as you embark on your respective journeys beyond this campus of Exam University, I urge you to strive for excellence in your chosen paths, but never forget that your achievements be rooted in a strong foundation of values that Exam stands for: excellence, integrity, and compassion. And let your success uplift not only yourselves, but also those around you. Congratulations once again, and may your futures be filled with boundless opportunities and meaningful contributions. Thank you, and God bless you all.
We express our gratitude for your valued thoughts. Thank you, Father. May I now call upon the Chairman Emeritus, Sri Rajiv Kaul, to deliver his address. Sir, please.
Thank you. Our dynamic and extremely accomplished chief guest, Mr. Mukundan, CEO and MD of Tata Chemicals, Father Kutina, Father Anthony Uri, Father Anthony Raj, members of our board of governors, deans, members of faculty and staff, graduating students and their family members, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is with the greatest of pleasure that I extend my personal welcome to all of you on this happy day when 643 students of our graduating classes of 22-24 are given recognition for their hard work, persevering effort, and indeed success. It is today that all of you, my young friends, participate in this landmark event as you enter the new exciting real world, one full of challenges and opportunities. May I extend to each and every one of you my warmest congratulations and request the audience to carry it with acclaim. It is also a very special privilege for me to extend my personal welcome to our chief guest, Mr. Mukundan, a most accomplished and dynamic corporate leader of our country who is driving with great vigor and extremely successfully an Indian company with global roots in Africa, in UK, and USA. I've had the pleasure of working with him at the CII, Confederation of Indian Industry, and at IMA, the All India Management Association. Mukundan, you honor us with your presence today. Ladies and gentlemen, please do join me in welcoming him in the warm tradition of Xaviers and Xaverians. My young friends and graduating classes, as all of you leave our campuses and go into your careers, you do so at a time when the world economy is in an extremely tough situation with the war in Ukraine, another war in Gaza, and further complications with Iran and Israel almost at war with each other. It is in these difficult times that your determination, your resilience, your innovative thinking, and the approach to face challenges that you have imbibed at our university will be of immense help to you in your journey. India, despite these problems, has the highest global rates for any global economy. We have a strong and stable government at the center, and this government is committed to deepening the reform process and firmly keep India moving ahead. And even though in different parts of our country, in many states, we have other parties providing leadership, all of them are interested in moving their state forward and aggressively wooing global investments. Furthermore, India, with a young aspirational population, like many of you, a rapidly growing middle class, an accelerated pace of urbanization, large investments in infrastructure, ensures that India's growth shall continue well into the future. Friends, it took Indian economy 60 years post our independence to touch the $1 trillion mark in the year 2008. The next trillion of our GDP was achieved in only 7 years, and in March 2015, we achieved that milestone. And despite the pandemic, over the next year, we achieved the third trillion. Today, my friends, we are at $4 trillion and well on the way to becoming the third largest economy, because today we are already the fifth ahead of the UK, and we shall overtake both the German and Japanese GDP economy in the next 3 or 4 years, and most certainly by 2030. And friends, it is in this backdrop of high growth and dynamism, both of political and corporate leadership, that all of you will be growing the organizations that you're going to work in. And I am sure that all of you will be an integral part of India's growth story, involved in building the India of tomorrow. An India which is strong, an India which is confident, an India which is vibrant, and indeed an India which gets increasing global respect. I have the full confidence that with the learnings all of you have imbibed at our Xavier's University, you will contribute in great measure towards the building of India's century. In this endeavor, I wish you good luck, Godspeed, and all success. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Your insights are deeply appreciated. Allow me to now extend a respectful invitation to our esteemed chief guest and convocation speaker, Sri R. Mukundan, to kindly deliver the convocation address. Sir, your words would honor us greatly. Please.
Greetings and good morning. Respected faculty members, esteemed guests, proud parents, most importantly, the graduating class, extraordinary graduating class of XIM University. It's an absolute privilege and a profound honor for me to address you on this momentous occasion. Today, as we gather to celebrate your remarkable achievements and bid farewell to one important chapter of your journey, and usher in the next, I'm actually filled with a huge sense of pride and optimism in future for all of you, as has been highlighted by Sri Rajiv Kaul. At the outset, let me thank Father Jerome Cotino, Father Anthony Owari, Father Anthony Raj, Sri Rajiv Kaul, and Professor Biswaroop Mishra for inviting me here to share my thoughts with you, and in that I seek your indulgence, sir. 34 years ago, I was seated exactly where you're all seated, in a much smaller room. We are only 40 students, but this is a huge hall, and compliments to XIM for building these huge facilities. A huge round of applause to XIM for having done that. I'm truly impressed. And I was seated where you're all seated with a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of energy, and I was a bit naive. And it happened at the time. And it happened to be also a time when I thought anything and everything is possible. And that was the innocence of thought with which I actually sat in those place where you're seated. Many years later, 34 years today, I still feel the same. It's tough to retain the same energy, same enthusiasm, and also innocence of thought, but that is the most important thing one can keep to move forward. It keeps you energized and focused. And as you stand at the threshold of new beginning, armed with knowledge, skills, experience acquired from this institution, I want you to take a moment to reflect on the significance of this and also on the opportunities which lie ahead. You will hear many say it is a VUCA world, volatile, unpredictable, complex, ambiguous. You will also hear a word that world is full of opportunities. Both are right. There are disruptive innovations, collaborative partnerships, which are shifting the lines of economy. Digital world has made usage more valuable than ownership. Actually, it's very critical. Usage is now more valuable than ownership. That's a big fundamental shift. However, that is not the only shift. In the next 35 years of your career, you will see a lot more shifts happening. When I joined, we had telex machine, fax machine, cyclostyling of paper, pagers. I put this as a list of, you know, what I call technology dinosaurs. You will have many more on the way as you go through your career. With that, how does one cope? And for that, I reflected on this, and I'm going to speak from my life experience up till now. But it is an experience of working for one enterprise. I have worked all my life for Tata. Within Tata, many companies, but still Tata. Sometimes when I tell people that this is my 34th year with Tata, many young graduates who join our company look in wonderment as if I'm one of the museum pieces. But let me assure you that monogamy in career is as good as monogamy in marital life. But you must choose your career well. And just equally, choose your firm well. And Also, let me not also forget that, you know, I had many indulgent bosses on the way. It is important to have supportive mentors, gurus, superiors in the organization. They have been pillars of my strength through my journey through Tartars. And it's been a great journey with immense opportunities. That's what a great, good organizations can provide. So I want to thank at this point of time Tata once again for being that enterprise which has supported me and many like me. It's difficult to come to a convocation full of insightful, intelligent, talented listeners and speak here. You know, what more gyan can you give? So I also did the most technologically advanced thing. I went to ChatGPT about a convocation speech. Seriously, I did. But in the end, I ditched it. For an occasion like this, it is more important to follow the lines which flow from your heart and experience the uncertainty of the moment. Hence, I come to the first point of what I wanted to communicate to you. With all that you have learned, there is no greater joy than living in the moment and experiencing it to the fullest and face the consequences of the same and learn more. Hence, if I were to wish something for all of you, it'll be many moments of spontaneity, many moments of joy, and many moments of learning. But for that, you must do always what only you can do, which is follow your heart. Don't lead someone else's life, but lead your own. When I started my career, I was not sure what I wanted to do. In fact, I was discussing this with Father Coutinho, and I just want to say that, but on reflection, I have benefited from being part of one organization. That brings me to the second point. It is not important to be sure of what you want to do, as long as you're in good company. In Delhi, where I grew up, they call it Sat Sangat. You will find your true calling, but in good company, you will find noble true calling. There's a big difference between true calling and noble true calling. A true test of Sat Sangat is by seeing what an organization person has done in the past. People are creatures of habit. So are organizations. If a person or organization has good habits, then it is surely going to be a better place and a place you can call Satsangat. Hence, all your life, try to surround yourself with good people. There are three simple words when I walked into Tata Bombay House, which I saw, which was on the, it's not there in the sense that it was an emblem there, which had the motto in Zoroastrian. It was Humta, Hukta, and Vrashta. Three words. And these three words, I think, have guided the Tatars, which is good thoughts, good words, and good deeds. So this may not matter now, but certainly I can tell you 34 years down the road, good company is what will keep you steady and sane. Not only does a good company and a circle of friends keep you steady and sane, it usually also keeps your needs simple. That takes me to the third point, have simple needs and wants. Don't complicate your life by wanting more and more. If your needs are simple, then even if you get something or lose something, you're not worried. Don't compare to others in terms of better car, bigger house, more exotic holidays. It's nice to have them, but not necessary to have them. What matters is the impact you have on others, not what you have for yourself. Hence, this is the most important point. What matters is not the size of purse, but the size of purpose. As you embark on this new chapter on this journey, I'm reminded of the words of our founder, Jamshedji Tata, who believed that in a free enterprise, community is not just a stakeholder, but is in fact the very purpose of its existence. So I think focus on the purpose, not on the purse. You will all lead, you're all leaders of today and tomorrow, you're entering a world full of opportunities and also full of difficulties, and you have choices to make. World will be a better place because of three forces of sustainability, technology, and innovation. You have great choices in career as an entrepreneur, as an employee. I've often wondered how do you make choices in our job between good and bad, and what principles to apply. We all know we have one planet for our current needs, and we need about 1.5 planet. But if we continue on the path we are on, we'll need three planets in the next 20 years, which is not possible. So we must change ourselves. I have great hope from this generation coming into workforce now that you will do what is right. Be sensitive to environment, society, and community. We need to focus on every aspect of this. We really cannot escape this now. The recent extreme events have shown nature can unleash if we continue to plunder Mother Earth. In whichever form, entity you create, work, please take this up as number one priority. In addition, we can't have the kind of difference between the haves and have-nots. We are all privileged. We must use our privileged position to make change and contribute to a more equitable world. Work towards building ethical, sustainable, happy organization. That's all I can wish for you. In a country as diverse and as dynamic as India, with rich cultural heritage and entrepreneurial spirit, I encourage you to embrace diversity, innovation, collaboration as drivers of progress. Be open to new ideas, embrace change with courage and resilience, and never lose sight of bigger picture. The opportunity to create what I call more inclusive, more sustainable, and prosperous futures for generations to come. Finally, let me come to two, three points, which is firstly, never stop learning. World is constantly evolving, and always stay ahead to remain curious, open-minded, and willing to adapt new ideas. Secondly, as Father said before, always lead with empathy and humility. The most effective leaders are those who listen deeply, treat others with respect, and are willing to admit when they are wrong. Remember that true leadership is not about having all the answers, but about empowering others to find their own solutions. Finally, never forget the importance of giving back as you climb the ladder of success. You will have long-term success. In this, I have often used the guidepost of a father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi. He had five principles. You can read his book, but he had only five principles. Let me again elucidate them as your guidepost. First one is ahimsa. Don't harm anyone. Second one is satya, which is follow the truth. Third is swaraj. Swaraj is not independence for the country. What he really meant was add a freedom at individual level. That's what swaraj meant for him. And fourth is sarvodaya, which is means serve all. And most importantly, what he believed was antayodaya, which is serve the last person in the queue. Let these be your guideposts in your decision and your work and life. So let me again go through what I said. Follow your heart. Don't lead someone else's life, but lead your own. It is not important to be sure of what you want, as long as you're in good company, satsangat. What matters is not the size of purse, but the size of purpose. And let five principles of Gandhi, which is ahimsa, satya, swaraj, antayodaya, and sarvodaya, be your guideposts. In close, let me express my heartfelt congratulations to each and every one of you. Today is a celebration of your achievements, your hard work, your unwavering determination to succeed. As you cross this stage and receive your degree, diplomas, know that you carry with you hopes and dreams of brighter tomorrow. So go forth, graduates, with confidence and conviction. The world awaits your brilliance, your passion, your boundless potential. As you go on this journey, I want to go to the one poet I always loved, T.S. Eliot. Just a background about him, Thomas Stearns Eliot was born in 1888, and he passed away in 1965, 1 year before I was born. He was a poet, essayist, playwright, and literary giant. He was born in St. Louis, Missouri. He lived in London. His notable works were Love Song of Alfred Prufrock, The Wasteland, The Hollow Men, Murder in Cathedral, and The Four Quartets. He won a Nobel Prize in 1948 for The Four Quartet, his masterpiece. Four long poems, Burnt Norton, East Coker, Dry Savages, and Little Gidding. He considered Little Gidding as his best of the Four Quartet. The last para of that Little Gidding ends with two lines. I just want to start there and then go to the next one. The last para, the first two lines are, all shall be well. All manner of things shall be well. All shall be well. All manner of things shall be well. But his masterpiece was in the beginning of the second last para, which he said, and this is what I wish for you. We shall not cease from exploration. We shall not cease from exploration. And the end of all our exploring will be to arrive where we started. And the end of all exploring will be to arrive at where we started and know the place for the first time. So happy journey, and thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Thank Thank you, sir, for your profound and enlightening words to the students and the audience here at XIM University. I now request Professor Andrew Datta, Dean, School of Human Resource Management, and the Acting Controller of Examination, to read out the citation conferring the Honorary Doctorate in Business Management on Sri R. Mukundan, Managing Director and CEO, Tata Chemicals Limited.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, ladies and gentlemen present in this hall, today, this convocation honors Mr. Mukundan Ramakrishnan, CEO and Managing Director of Tata Chemicals Limited, for his exceptional leadership and transformative contributions to the corporate world, particularly in the realms of sustainable business practices, innovation, and inclusive growth. His outstanding contributions exemplify the values and ethos we uphold here at XIM University, Bhubaneswar. Mr. Mukundan Ramakrishnan is the CEO and Managing Director of Tata Chemicals Limited, a part of the US $150 billion Tata Group. Tata Chemicals Limited is a leading supplier of choice to the glass, detergent, industrial, and chemical sectors. Tata Chemicals is a leading salt producer, the third largest soda ash manufacturer, and the sixth largest sodium bicarbonate manufacturer, and the sixth largest sodium bicarbonate manufacturer in the world, with the most modern facilities in India, the US, the UK, and Kenya. It is also a leading producer of food and pharmaceutical grade ingredients for customers worldwide. It has a strong position in the agricultural sector with its presence in the crop protection and seed business through its subsidiary company, Rallis India Limited. Tata Chemicals has world-class R&D facilities in Pune and Bangalore. Mr. Mukundan is a distinguished alumni of IIT Roorkee and a management graduate from FMS Delhi. In addition to being an alumnus of Harvard Business School, he is also a fellow of the Indian Chemical Society. He joined Tata Administrative Service of the Tata Group in 1990 and has worked with Indian Hotels Company, Tata Industries Limited, and Tata Autocom Systems Limited during his 33-year career with the Tata Group. Since his appointment as MD and CEO of Tata Chemicals in 2008, he has led the transformation of the company from a commodity chemical company to a science-based solutions company. He has ensured the company's strength through the growth of profitable businesses, the seeding of new ventures, and the restructuring of the unviable ones. As a result, profits grew 4 times and market capitalization grew 16 times to 28,500 crore rupees, that is about US$3.5 billion. Today, the company has operations in India, the USA, the UK, and Kenya, and delivers solutions in performance materials, nutrition sciences, agri-sciences, and energy sciences. The Innovation Center in Pune focuses on nanotechnology and biotechnology. It also operates a chemistry, synthesis, and seed technology center in Bangalore through its subsidiary, Rallis India Limited. Together, they house more than 235 scientists and technical experts and have filed more than 200 patents. The company is committed to embracing digital technology and advancing Industry 4.0, having developed and implemented over 48 artificial intelligence and machine learning models. The company, under his leadership, has committed itself to green growth with a science-based targets initiative committed of a 30% reduction in carbon by 2030 and net zero by 2045. As part of the climate change agenda, the company achieved a 17% year-on-year increase in renewable energy and 9% reduction in overall energy consumption. Circularity, another pillar of sustainability, involves recycling 87% of water and using 500 kilotons of waste material in production. Further, as part of its nature and biodiversity commitment, the company has helped communities harvest over 717 million cubic feet of water, planted 2.2 lakh mangrove trees in financial year 2023, and saved over 910 whale sharks. Through Tata Chemicals social enterprise, Tata Chemicals Society for Rural Development, over 2,500 youth have been skilled, 29,500 artisans have been impacted, 2,900 women have been empowered, and programs have been conducted for over 52,000 students. Mr. Mukundan is an ardent advocate of sustainability and inclusion and serves on industry forums like CII, BCCI, EFI, etc. He was the president of the Employers Federation of India, the Bombay Chambers of Commerce and Industry, and the chairman of the Confederation of Indian Industry, Western Region. In recognition of his outstanding achievements, leadership, and unwavering commitment to excellence towards industry, society, and government, XIM University Bhubaneswar proudly confers upon Mr. Mukundan Ramakrishnan this degree of Doctor of Business Management honoris causa on this day of convocation on April 20th, 2024 at Bhubaneswar.
Thank you, sir. With great regards, I invite our Chairman, Chairman Emeritus, and Vice Chancellor for conferment of the honorary doctorate on Sri R. Mukundan, sir. And also felicitate him for gracing our 10th convocation ceremony. Thank you, sir. I request our chief guest and convocation speaker, Sri R. Mukundan, sir, to present the medals for academic excellence, and request Professor Vishwaswarup Mishra, Dean Xavier Institute of Management, to announce their names.
It is indeed my pleasure to announce the names of the meritorious students who are being awarded gold medal for academic excellence. Unless otherwise specified, all the students pertain to the 22-24 batch. I will begin with School of Economics, MSc in Economics, Vice Chancellor's Medal for the best academic performer, Sichitaj Sahu. School of Governance and Public Affairs, Masters in Public Policy and Governance, Vice Chancellor's Medal for the Best Academic Performer, Khyati Kasyap. School of Communications, MA in Mass Communication, Vice Chancellor Medal for the Best Academic Performer, Deep Sengupta. School of Sustainability, MBA in Sustainability Management, Vice Chancellor's Medal for the Best Academic Performer, Rebecca Joy. School of Human Settlements, MBA in Urban Management and Governance, Vice Chancellor's Medal for the Best Academic Performer, Aditya Narayan Das. School of Human Settlements, Masters in Urban Regional Planning, Vice Chancellor's Medal for the Best Academic Performer, Saurabh Das. School of Rural Management, MBA in Rural Management. The first three rank holders and awardees of gold medals. Gold medal for Academic Excellence, first rank, Siddhant Datta Sahu. Second rank, Sanjana Pandey. Third rank, Pooja Sahu. Father MBD Bogart, gold medal for topper in development ethics seminar course, Sweta Panda. Odisha Jesuit Society, gold medal for the best performer, all-rounder, Kanchi Mohan. RLLE Ratna Award, commendation certificate with a cash prize of Rs. 5,000, Pooja Sahu. School of Human Resource Management, MBA in Human Resource Management, gold medal for academic excellence, first rank, Rupali Singhai. Second rank, Palak Dheer. And the third rank in absentia, Mriga Bharti. Shruti Chaudhary Award of Excellence, Rupali Singhai. Javier Institute of Management, Executive MBA, BM, 1 year full-time, class of 22-23. Diwan Chandgar gold medal goes to the first rank holder, Abhipsa Abhijita. Gold medal for academic excellence for the second rank, Sonu Kumar Ray. Third rank, Siddharth Rath. MBA in Business Management, class of 22-24, top 10 rank holders who are getting gold medals. First rank, Rohit Kumar Singh. Second rank, Bernie Sankar. Second rank, Rusil Patel. Third rank, Mani Sankar. Fourth rank, Deepak Asokan. Fifth rank, Dibya Kuswa. Sixth rank, Chirag Haswani. Seventh rank, Modha Byom Haris. Eighth rank, Tanmay Patnaik. Ninth rank, Akhil Bindal. 10th rank, Mohit Bhalla. 10th rank, Mohit Bhalla. Now the medals for outstanding performance. Odisha Jesuit Society Medal for Social and Ethical Perspective in Management, which is given to the topper in the Ethics and Sustainability course, Sarvanya Kamboj. Lita Mishra, Uncle Koti Gold Medal for Lady Topper, Dibya Kuswa. Dibya Kuswa also gets the Apurva Singh Gold Medal for Lady Topper. Ravi Sharma, Arsh Vidya, Gold Medal to the best all-rounder, Satya Swarup Jena. Dr. Professor Deepak Mishra Gold Medal for Topper in Information Systems Area Courses, Akanksha Kutriyar.
Thank you. I request everyone to please be seated. I now request, sir, to administer the pledge for the graduating students.
Graduating classes, please rise to take the pledge. We, the graduating students of XIM University Bhubaneswar, hereby pledge that we shall always endeavor to be scrupulously honest in the discharge of our duties as good citizens of the world, that we shall always endeavor to utilize our knowledge for the service of our country and the glory of our university, that in all circumstances we shall try to uphold the dignity of the individual and the integrity of the profession, that we shall, in word and deed, guard against all narrow loyalties and sectarian prejudices, and cherish with pride the basic unity of our country. You may please sit. All faculty members may please rise. On the recommendation of this faculty, the governing body is pleased to confer the Doctor of Philosophy degree on 6 students, 2-year MSc in Economics, 5 students, 2-year Master in Public Policy and Governance on 4 students, 2-year MBA Dual Master's Program in Sports Industry Management on 7 students, 2-year MA in Mass Communication on 12 students, 2-year Master's in Management Studies, Business Finance on 17 students, 2-year MBA in Sustainability Management on 17 students, 2-year MBA in Urban Management and Governance on 9 students, 2-year Master's in Urban Regional Planning on 5 students, 2-year MBA in Rural Management on 51 students, 2-year MBA in Human Resource Management on 104 students, 1-year Executive PGDM BIL on 39 students, 1-year Executive MBA on 18 students, 2-year MBA Business Management on 348 students. Faculty members may please sit down. I now request the chairman, chairman emeritus, and the vice chancellor to kindly award the degrees.
I request the deans of respective schools to present the graduating classes for the award of degree diploma.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is of great pleasure and honor to present before you the list of the graduating doctoral scholars. This year, 6 scholars are convocating in total, out of which 4 are present physically. I will present their names in a pairwise format, starting in the alphabetical ordering. Joshi KX. Jugal Kishore Mohapatra. Both scholars are from Xavier Institute of Management. Sayada Sahin, she is from the School of Human Resource Management. Tanmay Khuntia, he is from the School of Sustainability. Congratulations to all of you, and I now request Dr. Golak Sinat, Dean, School of Economics, to carry on with the proceedings. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Rahul. It is a pleasure to announce the name of students from School of Economics. who will be graduating today. I will read out the name. The first name is on the terms of merit and topper of the batch, and other names in alphabetical order. Shichita Sahu, gold medalist. Anumay Mudak and Bhaskar Das. Spandan Ganguly. Now I request Professor Vaishali Singh, Dean, School of Governance and Public Affairs, to take the proceedings further. Thank you.
From the School of Governance and Public Affairs, I am pleased to announce the names of graduating students of the Master in Public Policy and Governance. Khyati Kashyap Sunanda Deb. Thairing Tao Hojai. One student, Abhishek Ghosh, is convocating in absentia. Now I request Professor Arun Kumar Paul, Acting Dean, Xavier M. Leon Business School, to carry forward the proceedings.
Thank you, Professor Vaishali. Wish you all a very warm good afternoon. It is my absolute honor and utmost privilege as the Dean of the Xavier M. Leon Business School to present before you the graduating students of the Dual Masters Program in Sports Industry Management. The calling order is in alphabetical order, and we have Angshu Bhuiya, Naveen Tushar Lakra. Satish Narayan, Saurav Shaw. Shubham Mohanty. Two students, namely Kintali Praveer Pursti and Rishi Shangvi, are graduating in absentia. Hearty congratulations to and best wishes to all graduating students and the family members as you begin the new phase of your journey. Now I request Professor V. Vijay Kumar, Dean, School of Communications, to carry on with the proceedings. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Arun Paul. It gives me immense pleasure to announce the graduating batch of 2024 of MA Mass Communication. The first three students are in the order of merits and others in the roll number order. Deep Sen Gupta, Richard Pinto. Nikita Kariketa, Abhirup Badra. Andrew Vincent Gomes, Anushka Agarwal. Anvesha Karmakar, Rajveer Singh. Roshan D'Souza, Subham Kariketa. Now I request Professor P.K. Mohanty, Dean, School of Commerce, to take the proceedings forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Vijay Kumar. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm happy to present before you the graduating students of Master of Management Studies in Business Finance, class 2022-24. All the names are as per their roll numbers. Akshat Kumar and Sumita Ghatak. Bhushan Jhansi, Devanshu Ray Chaudhary. Devasri Champati Ray, Gauri Shankar Das. Krishan Dokania, Kusagra Kaushik. Muskan Bhutika, Priya Agarwal. Sai Subham Poy, Sojanya Heblikar. Tanvi Gupta and Tejasri Biramalu. Thank you and congratulations. Now I request Professor Sutapa, Dean School of Sustainability, to carry forward the proceedings.
It's my honor and privilege to present before you the graduating students of MBA in Sustainability Management, batch of 2022-24. The first three names are in order of merit and thereafter alphabetically. Rebecca Joy, ranked first gold medalist. Anju Biju, ranked first joint. Kakrala Fani Sita, ranked third. And Abhishek Aman. Gurbani Manku, Ritwik Chaube. Janani Ramesh, Kashish Prasad. Malvika Das, Manika Singh. Muhammad Muzaffar Adil, Pritesh Das. Subham Das Mahapatra, Soumya Bhushan Nanda. Shrishti Taranjit Kaur Minhas. And George Bobby Pothulil. Hearty congratulations, dear students, as you embark on your sustainability stewardship journey. May God bless you. Now, I would request Professor Kajri Mishra to present the graduating students of her school.
Good afternoon. It is a great pleasure and privilege to announce the names of the graduating students of the two programs of the School of Human Settlements. The first three names are in order of merit and thereafter by roll number. First, the MBA in Urban Management and Governance graduating students of the batch of 2022-24. The seven students who are present of the nine are: the first rank one, Aditya Narayan Das, and rank two, Vaibhava Srikriti Das. The third rank holder, Abhijit Rath, is receiving his degree in absentia. Devjani Pati and K. Divya Jyoti. Surya Prakash Kar and Anisha Anindita Swain. And Surup Mahapatra. Two students, Abhijit Rath and Nadia Chloe Henriks, are receiving their degree in absentia. Now the students of the Masters in Urban and Regional Planning program, rank one, Saurav Das. Rank two, Akanksha Mahapatra is receiving the degree in absentia. Rank three, Saujanya Raut. Madhumanti Das and Siddharth Das. One student is receiving her degree in absentia. Congratulations to the graduating students. I now invite Professor Neeraj Kumar, Dean, School of Rural Management, to take the proceedings forward. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I will read out the names of the graduating students who will be receiving their degrees for the MBA RM 2022-24. The first three names are in order of merit. Siddhant Datta Sahu, first rank holder. Sanjana Pandey, second rank holder. Pooja Sahu, third rank holder. Akanksha Panigrahi and Amrit Kumar Sahu. Anjali Shukla and Avilash Swain. Avipsa Bhatt and Asa Misra. Vidyalakshmi Biswal and Chinmay Kumar Sahu. Farha Khan and Ira Sharma. Isha Sharma and Simhadri Jashmita. Kanchi Mohan and Kaushiki Gupta. That's it. Shayed Mohammad Ali Mohammed and Morkar Monarch Patnaik. Amarnath Reddy and Nainika Ghosh. Neha Patel and Nikita Sahu. Neha, come fast. Nirbhate Panda and Nupur Das. Pradeep Mohanty and Priti Hajra. Priyesh Chaudhary and Ram Narayan Das.
Uh,
Ravi Shankar and Rohit Ashok. Sir Mischa Rath and Smriti Smita Panigrahi. Snehil Bhatnagar and Superba Mahapatra. Supriya, aage aajo. Aage aajo. Supriya Singh and Swaroop T. Saju. Sweta Panda and Tanuja Joshi. Tushar Patil and Vishal Pratap. Yaswardhan Bothra and Siddharth Sharma. Geeta Tripathi. I congratulate one and all, and I request Professor Andre Datta to take the processing forward.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege and honor to read out the names of the MBA HRM graduating students who would be receiving their degrees today. The first three names are in order of rank holders. First rank and the Shruti Chaudhary Award of Excellence for Women Topper in MBA HRM goes to Rupali Singhai. Second rank, Palak Dheer. Third rank in absentia, Mriga Bharati. Now the names are in roll number. Akanksha Verma and Akhil Mathur. Amiya Bhushan Das and Ananya Jena. Anjali Bhotra and Arsika Arya. Arup Anupam and Asima Panda. Ashutosh Behra and Badal Kumar Mallik. Chiranjeevi Mohanty and Debashish Kabi. Deblina Mondal, Isha Rudra, we need to synchronize. Gunturu Sinduja and I Ruchita. Kanak Saulani and Ketan Sehgal. Kaustav Chakravarti and Lipsa Patra. Madhusmita Kar and Maitri Vyas. Megha Shekhar, Manushri Ganguly. Varanya Das, Neha Shukla. Poonam Mahapatra and Pratiksha Sahu. Rohan Chauhan and Saurabh Gadde. Shubham Saurabh, Shraddha Agarwal. Shruti Rekha Mohanty and Shubhendu Shekhar Khuntia. Snigdha Kalra and Ahan Ranjan. Shovan Kumar Parida and Kodari Sriya Reddy. Suniti Dash and Rufi Haider. Jetling Nandan Power and Abhishek Abhinandan. Abhinash Sahu and Aishwarya Bajpai. I Akash and Animesh Pandey. Vidisha Satpati and Ashutosh Jena. Debasmita Panda and Bharti Rangnani. Diya Kapoor and Damanpreet Kaur. Akash Bhattacharya and Diksha Goyal. Janavi Saluja and Deepayan Mishra. Komal and Latika Goyal. Madhurakshi Ghosh and Michelle Matthew. Mayang Agarwal and Neha Senapati. Patil Aditya Ashok and Pratik Doshi. Prerna Khandwal and Radhika Agarwal. Rituparna Mishra and Samisla R. Nayak. Sai Sriman Pattanayak and Shubhangshi Jain. Shraddha Shri Pattanayak, Smriti Shraddha Prasad. Sheikh Muhammad Arif Billah and Solanki Samanta. Soumya Bharadwaj and Srija Mishra. Shubhashri Baliar Singh and Syed Muhammad Anas. Suyash Mahapatra and Deshdeep Nandi. Yuvraj Sahu and Nitish Kumar. Emil Mani Binoy. And Ubaid Afzal. I heartily congratulate all the graduating students of MBA in Human Resource Management, the class of 2022-24. I now call upon the Dean, School of Business Management, Professor Biswaswarup Mishra, to carry on the proceedings. Thank you.
I will begin with the Executive PGDM VIL 2022-23 batch. The certificates are given to Atif Hussain, Prasit Kumar Das, Rajendra Kumar Barik, Sumit Kumar, we will now take up the Executive MBA class of 22-23. The first three names are in order of merit for the top three rank holders. Abhipsa Abhijita, first rank, Sonu Kumar Ray, and Siddharth Rath. Other students as per roll number, Abhishek Kumar Patra, Amrit Mishra. Kamaksha Prasad Sarangi, Mayuk Mandal. Priya Khan, Rajarshi Das. And Sandeep Ghosal. Now we will take up the MBA in Business Management class of 22-24. The first 10 names are in order of merit for the top 10 rank holders. First rank, Rohit Kumar Singh. Second rank, Rusil Patel. Third rank, Mani Sankar. Fourth rank, Deepak Asokan. Fifth rank, Dibya Kuswa. Sixth rank, Chirag Haswani. Seventh rank, Modha Vyom Haris. Eighth rank, Tanmay Patnaik. 9th rank Akhil Bindal, and 10th rank Mohit Bhalla. Now the other graduating students as per roll number: Anchal Sarda, Pulluru Asis. Asna Bansal, Abhijit Rath. Abhishek Kar, Abhishek Mohanty. Abhayam Abhishek Panda, Avinash Satpathy. Ali Bhomik. Ananya Raut, Ankit Kumar Behera. Chinmay Prasad, Debasis Behera. Dilkas Jilani, Hardik Anirudh, Jagannath Prasad Khuntia. Kundan Lenka, M. Srinivas. Maina Kundu, Manas Arora. Omkar Sharma, Nadim Anjum Mulla. Prashant Raj Singh, Pranjali Desmukh. Prastuti Priyadarshini, Pranay Chatterjee. Rachita Swain, Pulak Sinha. Ritik Agarwal, Ritika Sahu. S. Amarjyoti, Sabyasachi Panda. Saksham Vaveja, Sai Sambit Das. Saloni Sahani, Saksi Lohia. Samprit Rath, Sania Saw. Sumendra Tripathi, Sankhadeep Datta. Saurav Andani, Sanskriti Jain. Adhiya Uchab Deepak Kumar, Tasi Parasampuriya. Aditya Bharadwaj, Aditi Agarwal, Aditi Agarwala. Aishwarya Chanda, Akash Das. Abhishek Sahu, Akshat Mehrotra. Abhishek Panda, Vishnu Sagar SB. Ayush Agarwal Agrawal, Himanshu Sharma. Harish Kumar Tulsiyan, Hardik Mishra. Kamlesh Sahu, Janvi Vedia. Kartik Lamba, Kanish Chauhan. Mukul Lundia, Mehak Lonial. Meher Kaur Chahal. Pankaj Kumar Sharma. Mehul Agarwal. Parul Gupta. Naman Saha. Radha Bagari. Payal Maiti. Divyans Rastogi, Radhika Agrawal, Rohan Sahu, Hemang Gandhi, Sakshi Sharma, Sai Krishna Raut. Sarvanya Kamboj, Samiksha Das, Satchit Bala Sriram, Saswat Patnaik. Satvi Tripathi, Satyaswarup Jena. Satyasiv Raut, Satyajit Das. Saurav Kumar, Subham Arora. Tamanna Patnaik, Tanmay Rai. Vaishnav Dwiz Asis, Vaishali Gupta. Yas Kumar Singh, Ronak Gupta. Akash Ranjan Das, Akanksha Maharana. Alkwa Rabbani, Alisa Rautri. Amarnath Sarangi, Aman Agarwal. Amya Anupam, Amisa Rath. Ananya Mahapatra, Amlan Bharadwaj. Anurag Chaudhary, Angel Singh. Bibharani Priyadarshini Raul, Ayush Bhargav. Dia Banerjee, David Paul, Jasani Rissel, Ashwin Kumar, Harshvardhan. Manas Ranjan Pujari, Kavya Mishra. Mistri Keur Kishor Bhai, Menon Nidhi Achyutan. Nandini Goel, Nancy Tyagi. Ananya Pradhan, Poluru Bhavya Grace. Prajyot Mishra, Pragyasri Behera. Rajatav Das, Rahul Sharma. Ramji Tripathi, Rakesh Kumar Das. Sai Kiran Biswal, Rathin Dev Sharma. Sefali Patnaik, Subham Sarogi, Sasang Sekhar Singh, Sovit Jethani, Sivank Jaiswal, Srija Datta, Sridatta Mahapatra, Saurabh Ghosh, Saugat Sekhar Hota, Ved Prakash Soni, Tanu Jagarwal, Akanksha Mahanti, Yashwant Reddy, Badvelu, Anisa Das, Anis Sinha, Ankita Sahu, Anjali Tevatia, Anmol Dutt Lakhera, Ankur Vaj, Anurag Mahanti, Ansuman Panda, Chaman Pradhan, Guru Prasad Patnaik, Devidat Sahu, Indar Bihani, Himanshu Lalani, Ipsita Chakrabarti, Mausumi Nandi, Konchada Mahesh, Ojaswini Panda, Nida Mehboob, Prasuk Jain, R Ronak Khandelwal, Richa Singh. Ritesh Swai, Madhav Bagri. Sai Kumar Nayak, Sarthak Spandan Mohanty. Satyam Chirania. Shruti Goyal. Suv Sandhu. Subhangi Joshi, Sivansu Gupta. Siddhant Sekhar Mishra, Siddhesh Sharma. Sneha Agarwal, Sumanta Pati. Saurabh Mahanti, Tanvir Mahanti. Tanvi Parikh, Vibhor Tyagi. Bidhi Srivastav, Yachna Agarwala. Aditya Mishra, Akanksha Agarwal. Ankita Pal, Antariksha Patnaik. Anupam Nag, Anurag Mahapatra. Ansuk Kamila, Anvesh Anjan Patel. Arvik Das, Aryaki Daw. Aryaman Tomar. Dhiman Minaketan Mishra. Ayush Nahak. Ritik Relhan. Ipsita Patra. Mandhare Mayures Milind. Krishna Yajnabrat Behera. Mrinal Singh Tarial. Manish Kumar Satpathi. Nikhil Kumar Linka. Muskan Agarwal. Pratyush Patnaik, Nipun Navin Jena. Naman Khandelwal. Pritish Raul. Ritvik Satpathi. Rishabh Jain. Kabra Rohan Nalok. Riya Sakhuja. Soumya Satpathi. Sonal Madan. Sauvik Sarkar. Somyansu Satabdi Das. Subham Swabhiman. Srinita Mishra. Sauradeep Sen, Sudipto Mohapatra, Tusar Jain, Tithi Bhattacharya, Akanksha Kutriyar, Vishal Huda, Avinash Sahu, Avinav Swain, Aditya Dhakre, Achyutam Jha, Astik Acharya, Akshat Jaiswal, Orosis Das, Avinash Kumar, Vivek Agarwala, Chinmay Vasu, AVS Nikita, Isan De, Hunar Jagwani, Jayasri Karmakar, Isan Chaudhary, Krishna Prasad Das, Kritika Kondoi, Manish Saraf, Sitish Kumar Sinha, Megha Dhal, Manisha Panda, Nishtha Sinha, Naman Chaudhary, Pritiparna Panda, Nitish Das, Priyanshu Saha, Pritish Puhan, Rishabh Jain, Priyanka Pal, Ruchi Hota, Roshan Aditya, Saswat S. Nadagoda, Rusali Kumar, Sujit Kumar Sahu, Shreya Datta Roy, Sumit Kumar Sarangi, Sumesh Raut, Sunidhi Bhatia, Sumukh Gopal Kanpilewar, Swapnil Parida, Susil Gyavli, Swarnabhi Tripathi, Shreya Bhattacharji, Swarnav Swain, Syed Akbar Abbas Jafri, Vishal Sarangi, Ansak Panda, congratulations to all the graduating students.
Okay.
All the graduating students may please rise. besides the candidates who are present here, and there are others who have been found qualified for the award of degree or diploma as the case may be, but could not attend the convocation, I now request the chairman, Father Jerome Kuchina, SJ, to confer on behalf of the Board of Governors the degree in Doctor of Philosophy, 2-year MSc in Economics, 2-year Masters in Public Policy and Governance, 2-year MBA, Dual Masters Program in Sports Industry Management, 2-year MA in Mass Communication, 2 years Masters in Management Studies, Business Finance, 2-year MBA in Sustainability Management, 2-year MBA in Urban Management and Governance, 2-year Masters in Urban and Regional Planning, 2-year MBA in Rural Management, 2-year MBA in Human Resource Management, 1-year Executive PGDM BIL, 1-year Executive MBA in Business Management, and 2-year MBA in Business Management, as the case may be, on these candidates who are present and on others in absentia.
By the authority vested in me as the chairman of the Board of Governors, I award you the degree in Doctor of Philosophy, 2-year MSc in Economics, 2-year Master in Public Policy and Governance, 2-year MBA Dual Master's Program in Sports, Industry and Management, 2-year MA in Mass Communication, 2-year Master's in Business Finance, 2-year MBA in Sustainability Management, 2-year MBA in Urban Management and Governance, 2-year Master's in Urban and Regional Planning, 2-year MBA in Rural Management, 2-year MBA in Human Resource Management, 1-year Executive PGDM VIL, 1-year Executive MBA in Business Management, and 2-year MBA in Business Management, and I charge that by thought, word, and deed, you prove yourself worthy of the award.
Thank you, and congratulations to all the students. Everybody can please be seated. I now invite the Registrar, Father S. Anthony Raj, SJ, to propose the vote of thanks.
Esteemed Chief Guest of the Day and the Convocation Speaker, Dr. R. Mukundan, Managing Director and CEO, Tata Chemicals Limited, Reverend Father Jerome Kuchina, Honorable Chairman, Board of Governors, Exim Society, Shri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus, Board of Governors, Exim Society, respected members of the Board of Governors, Exim Society, esteemed Vice Chancellor, Reverend Dr. Father Anthony Aruari, respected deans, faculty colleagues, staff, dear parents, dear alum, and my dear students. I begin by thanking God, Goddess Almighty, for bringing us all here, for keeping you safe and healthy in these 2 years that you have spent in Exim University, and for making us see the light of day. Thank you, dear students. You are the cause of our joy and our celebration at this moment. Farewell. Make us proud. Dear parents, well wishers, you gave your sons and daughters to us. Now we give them to various industries and organizations. Thank you for your trust in us. I thank Dr. R. Mukundan, Managing Director and CEO, Tata Chemicals Limited, for sparing us, giving us time, and speaking from the heart. You indeed said that these are not from ChatGPT, but they are directly from the heart. And you asked us to follow our hearts, follow our noble true calling through Satsangat and simple living. Thank you for your valuable words of encouragement and inspiration as the convocation speaker. Shri Rajiv Kaul, we thank you, the Chairman Emeritus, for your motivational direction over three decades. Reverend Father Jerome Kutina, Honorable Chairman, Board of Governors, we thank you for your constant guidance. We are thankful to our dear Vice Chancellor for his inspiring leadership and taking the university from strength to strength. We are grateful to our Chief Finance Officer and Deputy Registrar, Old Campus, for timely dispersal of the resources that we needed for this occasion. Dear deans and faculty, congratulations. 2 years of hard work, 2 years of mentoring, and we have seen the result. I especially want to thank the two deans who did their duty during this occasion, Professor Biswaswarup Mishra and Professor Andrew Datta. Thank you, dear entire administrative team. Most of us have worked very hard for this particular occasion. Thank you. Thank you, IT team, the non-teaching staff, the program officers, the program assistants who accompanied the graduating classes throughout these 2 years and who walked literally kilometers just now, you know, ushering the certificates. Thank you, dear choir led by Niral Tirki, for setting the ambience for this occasion. Dear friends from the press and media, brought in by Team Illuminatics and our own program officers, thank you for spreading the good news that is XIM University. We also thank assistants and student volunteers from the School of Communications for their AV production. Thank you, Jigisha, for anchoring this event so very well. Thank you, everyone, for participating in this 10th convocation. Continue to be safe, be healthy. God bless you.
Thank you, Father, for your words of appreciation.
I now declare the 10th convocation of XIM University closed.
I request the audience to please rise for the national anthem.
Uttal jalati taranga Prabha shubha naame jaage Prabha shubha aashish maange Jaage tab jay gaatha Jan gan mangal daayak jay hai Bharat bhagya vidhata Jay hai jay hai jay hai
As you step out into the world with your degree in hand, remember that this is just the beginning of your lifetime of learning and growth. Congratulations on your convocation. I thank one and all for your presence and gracing this occasion at XIM University. The audience is requested to wait till the academic procession leaves the auditorium. Thank you. Thank you.
Look, sir,